Hello, welcome to this how-to video. My name is Andrea Schumann. I'm a support architect for SAP Cloud ALM. In this video, I will demonstrate how to set up all monitoring use cases in SAP Cloud ALM for SAP S/4HANA, SAP Business Suite, and SAP Employee Central Payroll. I will show you how you check the technical prerequisites for the setup, how to set up the push data collection in the managed system, how to select the monitoring use cases, and how to verify that the data collection in SAP Cloud ALM is activated. You need to make sure that your managed ABAP system meets the technical prerequisites to be able to successfully perform the setup. You also have to make sure that your user and the technical user that you plan to use for running the data collection background job have the appropriate authorizations. For the latest updates on prerequisites and needed authorizations, please check the SAP Cloud ALM for Operations Export portal under Setup Managed Services ABAP On-Premise System. A link to the Export portal is available in the description of this video. To perform the push data collection setup, log on to the Managed System and call the transaction /n/sdf/alm_setup. Enter a name for the new SAP Cloud ALM destination and press the Enter key to activate the subsequent buttons and input fields. Click on the button Update Destination. In the pop-up, you have to enter the information from the SAP Cloud ALM service key. The easiest way to fill in all the required fields is to paste the entire JSON string using the button Paste Service Keys. The UI will select the appropriate information from the JSON string. Press the OK button to create the RFC destination. The destination will be called ZSDF_, followed by the name you chose for the target ALM destination. You can find it in transaction SM59 under Type G RFC destinations. The target ALM root URL will be filled in automatically from the service key JSON file in the previous step. Enter the username of the technical user you want to schedule the job under. Press the button Register. A new job will be scheduled for the data collection. After the registration, the LMS ID will be displayed. The LMS ID is the technical ID of the managed system in the landscape management of SAP Cloud ALM. The last step is to select the use cases you want to activate. Click the Activate Use Cases button. Activate the use cases you want to use by checking the checkbox in front of them. You can change the selection later on. This concludes the setup in the managed system. The following steps are performed in SAP Cloud ALM. No further configuration is necessary, as the push data collection setup activates the standard monitoring as per the selected use cases. I will show you how to check that the push configuration was successful. First, I will check that the ABAP system was created successfully in the Landscape Management app in SAP Cloud ALM. You find the Landscape Management app in the group Administration. Open the Landscape Management app. Go to On-Premise Systems. Here you will find the newly created ABAP system in which I performed the push configuration. Open the system details. Under Logical Systems, you will see the client for which the setup was performed. This is especially important for the use cases Business Process Monitoring and Integration and Exception Monitoring, as these use cases collect client-dependent data. The data collection in the use cases was activated automatically. Let's verify the activation. You find all applications under SAP Cloud ALM for Operations. Open the Business Process Monitoring application. Open the Configuration tray. Open the Systems tray. Here you will find the ABAP system. As you can see, the data collection is set to active. KPI data is already available for the system. Now open the Integration and Exception Monitoring application. To see data or change the configuration, you have to add the ABAP system to the scope for the application. Open the scope selection. Select the ABAP system. Open the configuration tray. You can find the ABAP system under Services. The data collection is already activated. In our example, you can see that monitoring data is already available. For information on further use cases, please refer to the SAP Cloud ALM for Operations Expert portal. This concludes the standard setup for the monitoring of SAP S/4HANA, SAP Business Suite, and SAP Employee Central Payroll. Thank you for watching this video. You now know how to set up monitoring for SAP S/4HANA, SAP Business Suite, and SAP Employee Central Payroll with SAP Cloud ALM. For further information regarding the technical setup, feel free to consult the SAP Cloud ALM for Operations Expert portal, which is continuously updated with the latest news. A link to the expert portal is provided in the description of this video.